Good day to all prolific engineers. Today we're going to learn how to dismantle a signal carrier, how to dismantle and couple all the components of a serial carrier, starting from the carrier shutter, the mark stripe, and the chip contacts. So that's it for today. So what you are seeing now is what is called a signal carrier. A signal carrier. So I will start now to dismantle it while I guide you throughout the process. All signal ATMs, Wincor Nixdorf or Diebold Nixdorf, uses this same carrier. Although there might be minor changes in them, but all of them uses this signal carrier. Next time I can still teach you how to dismantle and couple a serial carrier, but it's no longer much in use again. So this is a signal carrier. I'm losing it right now. If you look very well, you see bunch of rollers. A belt and all those things joined together, they turn the rollers in the carrier. This is the upper part of the signal carrier. The upper part is where you have the chip contact. The chip contact, the flex you are seeing right now is a flex of a chip contact. The chip contact reads the chip on your card. Now below the carrier is where we have the signal magnetic stripe or signal read head, or you can also call it signal magnetic read head. So that one reads the black side on your card. If you look at the back of your card, you will see a black line. The back of your carrier, you see one black thick line. So it's a function of the signal magnetic stripe to read that portion, and that's where your details, your name is stored in, your biodata is stored in. You know, you can notice that when you insert your card into the ATM, it tells you welcome so and so, your name and all that. That's where your name and data is stored. So that's the first one that makes contact with your card and reads your name. So after that one passes through, it will now proceed to the chip contact side that will now perform help to perform a transaction on your account. So I'm losing the carrier board. This is a carrier board, a signal carrier board. Be careful when losing a signal carrier board. These are the shutter cables, the signal carrier shutter cables I'm losing. Be careful in order not to pull out or damage any of the pins or anything on the board. This is a signal magnetic stripe I'm removing right now. These wires are for the sensors. I'm sorry that my hand is blocking most of the things I'm doing. Just bear with me. This is a signal carrier. A signal carrier board. So this is the carrier. I've removed the casing of the carrier. Now let me lose the shutter of the carrier. The carrier shutter. Don't confuse this with the shutter, the CMD shutter. This is just a small signal carrier shutter. Now, this shutter, we're going to learn how to dismantle the shutter and how to couple it back. This is where your card enters from. This green lever, if you try to pull your card, it will press a solenoid there. There's a solenoid there, and the thing will open and your card will go through. So that's it. Let's lose the carrier shutter. I'm losing the carrier shutter right now. If you watch closely, you'll see what I'm doing. If your carrier shutter is misbehaving, making sounds like quack, 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 all those kind of sounds, or is not accepting card, if you try to pull a card through the carrier, the card is not entering. You have to seize and dismantle the carrier shutter. It also has what is called a preheat sensor. Yes, that's the way to lose that stuff. If you look closely, that's a preheat sensor. The preheat sensor, when you try to pull your card in the right direction, that's what shows the ATM that you are inserting your card in the right direction. And you observe that if you are putting your card in the wrong direction, it doesn't accept your card. So that preheat sensor, that's what allows the machine to know whether you are inserting your card in the right direction or in the wrong direction. You can also lose out the preheat sensor, but this is a newer version. It's hard to lose out, so you might just pull it out a little bit and clean it. Just pull it out a little bit and clean it. So that's it, the preheat sensor. So let's go further. If you've cleaned your preheat sensor, you can clean your preheat sensor with a brush. After cleaning your preheat sensor and everything is okay, then we can go further to lose the solenoid part. The solenoid part, if you observe very well, you see that we have a spring and a green lever at that solenoid part. If the spring is not okay, we also have a white foam that used to cushion the effects of the spring. If that spring is not springing well, it's not okay, it's hooking or something, you will observe that if you press that green lever, it will go front and hook. It won't come back. So what we normally do, we lose out the green lever. We now work on this. So that's it. So this metal is what used to close that carrier shutter. So this is the solenoid. This is the solenoid that tells it when to close and open. Okay. So let's start coupling back. Let's couple the preheat sensor back. So there's nothing much in coupling the preheat sensor back. You just have to tie back the plastic you just loosed. So I'm coupling the preheat sensor. So as you can see, it's just only one screw that is holding it, so it's coupled right now. So let's go back to the solenoid. Let's go back to the solenoid. The solenoid, as you can see, it has a direction it enters from. You can't turn it the other way around. Now this spring, we extend it, but this my own is okay. So, but if your own is not okay, extend it, drag it, pull it outward if it's not springing well. So drag it, pull it out, then you can now put your foam. That foam is just to cushion the effects of the spring going up and coming down. So you now put your spring back, then put it the same way I'm putting my own. Remember that metal enters first and it has a particular direction. That side that has that white stuff, it enters into that hole. So if you turn it the other way around, it will enter. So now that it has entered, so we will now put the green lever on the solenoid. Just do it exactly as I'm doing my own now. It's very simple. If you're having any issue with it, just be very careful. Do it carefully and the thing will enter properly. So there's a hook on that green lever, you hook it to that metal. So once you hook it, it's springing well. Then now what is left for us is to tight that solenoid to the plastic body. Now there are two screws that are holding it at the back. I have to tie these two screws back. So I'm tightening the screws right now. I'm tightening the screws right now. So that's it. So after tightening the screws, I will also tie the one at the front. And after doing that, you need to press you need to press the green lever to know if it is still springing properly. If it is not springing properly, you can still loose that solenoid and work on that spring again. instead of you finishing everything and the thing will not work, yes, make sure that the thing is springing properly, nothing is hooking it. So now I'm coupling the front one, so it has a direction, it has a hook. So once it enters, you just have to use one screw to hold it. So I'm tightening it right now. It's very simple. So now we have to put the cover of the pre-head sensor side. So to put the cover back, I have to press that green lever before I push it in. I hold down the green lever, then I push it in. So then now I will now couple it back. So after coupling it back, you now couple the one that is covering the mouth. It's quite simple to just, it has a direction, just turn it to that direction, then it will enter. So that's how to work on the carrier shutter. Anything you need to do on the carrier shutter, that's just what you need to do. The solenoid, the spring, the pre-head sensor. Make sure you brush everything, let everything be very clean. Once everything is clean, the spring is springing well, you are good to go on your carrier shutter. Then let's go further, let's learn other things too. Now this is a senior magnetic stripe or senior reed head. Then this green stuff is covering it, so I need to remove that green small plastic before I can remove the senior magnetic reed head. Then always remember to put that green stuff back, although even if you didn't put it back, the carrier will still work. So you have to press, there's a lever there, you have to press it down before you can remove the magnetic stripe. Now this magnetic stripe, if it's worn out too much, yes, if it's worn out too much, it won't read the black side on your card. If it's worn out, it won't read. It will tell you, thank you, please take your card. Once you insert your card, it will tell you, thank you, please take your card. So if you are changing a magnetic reed head, you have to clean that place with your brush. Make sure that that place is clean. There's no cobweb, there's no dust or anything inside it. There's no something like paper. So clean it properly, then you can insert your new one. Then remember to couple that green small plastic back to it. So that's how to lose a senior magnetic reed head. So now we'll now put it back. So watch the direction I'm putting it back. This is how I normally hold my magnetic reed head while putting it back. Then I press down that lever down there. Then once I press it down, I just, yes, hook it inside, the thing enters. You know, when I press it down, there's another lever here, that one will go up, allowing me to put that magnetic reed head inside. So we are done with that magnetic reed head. Roll it out, couple that green plastic back. So now I'm going to show you how to work on the chip contact. What I'm going to lose right now is the chip contact base. The chip contact base. I'm losing the chip contact base. So once it's out, I will now show you how to dismantle the chip contact base, how to remove the chip itself. Because if you want to work on the chip contact, or you want to replace the chip contact, you are not going to replace the whole base. You are only going to replace only the chip. So you have to learn how to change only the chip and not the whole base. Some engineers cannot change the chip. So if you know you cannot change that chip, so be very attentive to understand how to change the chip. So you know that side of your card that looks as if it's the same card of a phone. This part of the chip that looks like pins, that's where read that portion of your card that looks like SIM card. So the chip contact, it hooks you to your bank. You can make your transactions. if any of those chips, if any of those metal is a little bit bent, it can't read your card. If it's a little bit bent, you can't read your card. If it's just slightly bent, you can use your flat screwdriver to bend it back or to realign it again. So now I'm going to lose the chip contacts. I'm going to lose the chip out of the base. So you normally use your flat, you make use of your flat to lose it. So I'm losing it right now. So I'm losing it right now. So there's a part that has a DPS sensor. So that part is hooked to a plastic base. So you'll be careful when dealing with that place, because if that sensor is not well aligned, it will be making one back sound when you plug the carrier back. So I'm trying to remove the chip from there. You have to push it front, pull it up, it will come out. So now you disengage the spring from it. There's a spring hooking it, so you disengage it from it. That's the spring. It's a very tiny spring and it's very powerful. So once it's out, I can now lose that side that has that DPS sensor. That's what I'm trying to remove. So I'm removing the clip that is hooking it. It's out. Just be very careful with this DPS sensor. It's very fragile. So the clip that is hooking it, I have to remove it. So I'm removing the chip from the chip contact base. So this is the chip. The chip is finally out. So when you want to replace a chip contact, a senior chip contact, this is what exactly you will be given. They'll give you this chip. So you, as a prolific engineer, your work now will be to lose out the chip contact base, remove the old chip, and fixing this new chip. So these are the chips. So then if you lose it and all of them are well aligned, it means it's okay. This is a solenoid. Solenoid plays a major role in ATM. That's a solenoid. Those are the rollers and sensors. So these wires are connected to the carrier board. They bring power to the solenoid. So it's also one of the major work. These chips have to be well aligned. Sometimes the first one, that first leg I'm touching right now, so most times it normally goes front. It's normally up and more front, more than the others. It's just normal. This is the DPS sensor. So that is what is used to pin the DPS sensor to its position. Yes, I've removed it, because I will need to put it back. This spring helps to position the chip contact base, but I don't need it for now until I finish coupling my chip contact. I just remove it to make the coupling easier. So you have to that hook, you have to put back the down part first. Yeah, right. So once it's inside, you can now continue with the rest of the work. So what I'm going to do next is to put my chip contact. So see the direction I'm going to use to put it. If you watch closely, you see that I'm going to pass it from the under at the extreme end. Yes, I'll pass it from that side. So if you are doing your own, pass it from that same direction too. So you have to put back the spring. That spring, then you use your finger to pull that spring up, hook it on that chip, the head of that chip. So after hooking it to the head of that chip, allow it to slide inside, but you have to guide it through as it slides inside. Once it slides inside, it's okay now. It's okay now. So if you check well, you see that the solenoid will be springing properly once you put it well. So in what's left now is for us to put the DPS sensor. So you have to put that tiny hook back so that I can use it to pin at that one I've already placed there. So I'm putting it. It's clipped. Yeah, it's okay. So, but you have to make sure that it's looking straight. If it's bent downward, it will be misbehaving. The carrier will be making abnormal sounds and it will not work. So most times if I fix it, I normally use my flat to ensure that it's stable, it's flat and stable. It's not bent downward or it's not bent upward. It's not slanting up or not slanting down. You understand? So that's how to fix it. So after fixing it was not left for me is to just guide this thing, the flex through. Just be careful with that flex. So I'll just guide it through and hook it. There's a hook there where I'm supposed to hook it. I'll just hook it there. I'm done with the chip contact. I'm done with the chip contact. Also, although we normally change that solenoid most times if it's misbehaving, but that's once in a long while. So now I'm going to couple the chip contact base back to the carrier. So remember to put that spring you removed back, that thick spring you put. Remember to put it back. Because without that spring, it won't have the pressure to lap properly. It will just be doing as if it's having a gap inside. So yes, that's basically how to put a chip contact base. So hold it with one hand, then bring your screws. It has long screws. It has part of the longer screws in the carrier. So even if you lose all your screws, look for the longer ones and use it to couple this chip contact because it makes use of the longer ones. So I'm coupling the chip contact base. Coupling the chip contact base, make sure you tight all the screws properly. So after coupling the chip contact base, the next thing in line now is to couple our shutter to it. So I'm coupling my shutter to it. So the shutter is in place now. The shutter is in place. It's now to guide it and screw it. So the shutter, it makes use of long screw, but not as long as the ones for chip contact base. It's not as long as the chip contact base one, and is a little bit longer than the normal screws. So it has two screws, only two screws that are guiding it. So after that, yeah, the shutter has three wires. It has three wires, one for the solenoid, one for the anti-skimming, one for the read head, the pre-head sensor. So we're going to fix our senior carrier board back. It has lots of ports, but it doesn't mean that you're going to use all the ports. At least there'll still be one or two more ports left after we've coupled all our wires. So now I normally start with the shutter, the carrier shutter. I normally start by fixing. So just watch me as I'm putting all these wires. I'm sorry, my hand is blocking the road. So after that one, I put the one for the chip contact. I put the one for the chip contact. That's the chip contact flex. Yes, it's in. Then I now turn it upside down to be able to put the magnetic stripe flex and some other wires I couldn't put when it was turned the other direction. So I'm putting the senior magnetic stripe flex. So that's it. Once the flex is inside, you know the direction you are putting the flex. The direction that has the metal part faces downward. So after putting the flex, be careful with all these flex because they are very fragile. You know, you have to put the board before you put the other metal casing. So after I finish putting the board, is now the next step will now be to align the board properly, then bring the casing, the plastic casing of the board, and screw it in. It normally has two screws, a long screw and a short screw. So this is how to fix in the plastic cover for the carrier board. Put the short screw, tight it, then put the long one and tight it. So now the next one I put is the upper cover. The upper cover, I just set it properly, guide it through, and I tight my screws. Then I tie the lower base, guide it properly as I'm doing mine. Once you guide it properly, you screw it in, tight your screws. So after that, the one that will be the last to enter is the side cover. The side cover, that's the last I normally put, because that's the last one you're going to put. After tightening the last screw, that's the end. You've finally coupled your car reader, your senior car reader. Congratulations for doing that. Thank you for watching this video, and I wish you all the best in your quest to become a more prolific and professional engineer.